Hello, students of class 8. Today I am going to teach you from subject English lesson number 1. You know, lesson number 1, the name of the lesson is the wind cap. Wind cap means a cap full of wind, a cap full of wind, written by Jane Yolen, a lady writer. And she wrote many books for you, for particularly for the students. Here is a story. A widow mother had a boy, and the boy wanted to be a sailor. There was once a lad, lad means boy, who wanted to be a sailor, but his mother would not let him go to the sea. His mother did not want that her dear son would go to the sea, because his mother knew that there was some danger in the sea, so his mother did not give permission to go to her dear son. She would say to her dearest son, "Child, what do you know of sailing?" Because the boy did not know about sailing. So the mother would say again and again, "You are a farmer's son. You know the turn of the seasons and the smell of the soil, but you don't know the sea." Normally, the son of a farmer knows about the turn of the soil, about the smell of the soil, but when the boy wanted to go to the sea, his mother would not give permission to her dearest son. Now the boy, whose name, the name of the lad of the boy was John, and who had always obeyed his mother. The boy always obeyed his mother, so when his mother did not give him permission to go to the sea, the boy did not go there. So the boy went about his farm work, went to the field for farm work with a heavy heart, sadly. But the boy did not again mention the sea, because the boy cherished a strong desire in his heart to be a sailor. So he did not again mention the sea. One day he had been walking behind the plow. One day the boy was plowing, was walking in the field. He all but ran over a teeny turtle, green turtle on a cloud of dirt. While the boy was plowing in the field, he was run over a turtle. The color of the turtle was green and small too. He picked the turtle. When the boy saw the turtle in the cloud, he picked it up and set it on his head, where he knew it would be safe. The boy knew that if he would put the turtle on his head, it would be safe. So the boy would put the turtle on his head. When he was done with plowing, when the boy completed his work, he plucked the turtle from his head. When he plucked the turtle from his head, to his utter surprise, he found that it had turned into a teeny green fairy man that stood upon his palm and bowed back. With his utter surprise, surprisingly, the boy saw that when the boy plucked the turtle after finishing his work. The turtle changed, the turtle turned into a green fairy man, and the fairy man bowed on his palm. I thank you for your kindness, the fairy man said to the boy. Tell me your heart's desire and I will grant it to you for saving my life, said the fairy. As soon as the boy saw that the turtle changed into a green fairy man, the fairy man wanted to know the boy's heart's desire, and the fairy man would give his desire, would fulfill his desire instantly. So he said, I thank you for your kindness, tell me your heart's desire and I will grant it to you for saving my life. John bowed back but said nothing because he obeyed his mother. His mother did not give permission to go to the sea, but he had strong desire to go to sea, so he kept quiet. Although his heart yearned, had strong desire, yearned means strong desire to go out to the sea, he did not express his wish. The green fairy man could read a heart easily, so he said, I see you wish to go sailing, John's face answered for him. When we go in front of a mirror, we can see all things of our face. Like that, the fairy man would see the John's, the boy's heart's desire. So the fairy man wanted to know the desire of the boy. Next unit. Since you put me on your head like a hat to keep me safe, I shall give you a different kind of cap in return, the kind sailor most desired. The fairy man wanted to give a kind of hat, a kind of cap to John, because John saved its life, putting it on his head like a hat. So the fairy man wanted to give a kind of hat like of that, a cap full of wind. But there's one warning, no human hand will ever be able to take it off. The one of the cap was that no human hand would take it off from head. Then with a blink, the fairy man disappeared, leaving a striped cap behind the boy. Here telling this, the fairy man left the place, vanished from the place, leaving a striped cap behind the boy, behind John. Young John put the cap on his head and ran home to his mother very pleasantly or very happily. No good will come of the wind cap, she said. When John returned home with the cap and his mother saw the cap, his mother told him that there was no good in the cap, but the lad would have none of her cautions. The boy, John would have none of her, of his mother's cautions. The very next day, putting on the sailor's cap, he ran off to the sea he most desired. On seeing a ship anchored means a ship came near the land, anchored near the shore, he requested the captain of the ship to take him along to the ship. Thus began his first सी एवर वॉयेज सी जर्नी स्टार्टेड इन दिस वे द वॉयेज सी जर्नी स्टार्टेड व्हेन द कैप्टन ऑफ द शिप टूक हिम इन द शिप वेल द विंड कैप वर्क्ड द विंड कैप वर्क्ड एज द फेयरी हैड सेड द फेयरी सेड दैट व्हेनेवर यू कॉल द विंड फ्रॉम वन डिरेक्शन इट विल कम क्विकली सो he had said but that one condition prevailed now that was both bad and good the cap had both sides good and bad it was bad side it was bad because John could neither take the cap off before his captain nor at bedtime it was the bad side of the cap One could neither take the cap off before the captain, before one person or nor at bedtime. And it was good because neither could he lose the cap nor could it be stolen from him. The good side of the cap that one could not take the cap or one could not steal the cap from him it was good side since it was wind that sailors called for it was the wind the sailors called for desired for very much and wind that John could supply he soon became very popular when it was needed to call wind from any direction John could supply the wind and in this way John became very popular on the ship when he twisted the cap he could summon means call for the east wind and the west wind north and south he could also turn it to call both the north as well as the south wind by twisting John could call in the west east north or south wind as the sailors needed the captain would therefore never part with his prize sailor and let him ashore John became very important in the ship so the captain did not give him permission to go to ashore for a year and a day John did not set foot on land in this way John did not set foot on land for a year and a day he saw nothing but the charming of the waves of the sea soon there grew in his heart a strong desire to see the land or to go to his mother because for a long time he spent on the ship let me go ashore just for one day he begged the captain when they had sighted land in this way when the captain and other sailors saw land John requested the captain to go to the land or to go to his mother to return his mother he promised he would return but the captain was unmoved John promised to return soon but the captain did not give permission to go to the land or to his mother however John could not stop dreaming of the land when the captain did not give permission to John to go to the land or to his mother then he was dreaming of the land one quiet afternoon he lay fast asleep and fell to dreaming again while one afternoon John was sleeping he fell to dreaming again unknown to him The sheep stood up so from his old farm. In his dream, John saw that the sheep upset from his old farm. In John's dream, the seasons turned rapidly, quickly. And as each turn, so did John in his bed. Consequently, the cap on his head twisted. In his dream, when John twisted his head, the cap also twisted round and about. In this way, the cap called up a squall, very high wind from the clear sky that hit the ship without a warning. The wind had been whirling about the boat, tearing the sails and slapping and the spars. The ship became fell in danger. It's his fault. The other sailors and captain felt that it was the John's fault for the ship's danger. The sailors cried out. They shouted in anger and fear that tried to rip the cap off from John's head. Well, they are unsuccessful. The sailors wanted to snatch the cap from John's head, but they did not succeed. Well, for it was a fiery cap. It was the warning of the cap. They pulled it and twisted it, and so the squall became a storm. When the sailor twisted it quickly, the squall became a storm, the mightiest they had ever seen. The captain ordered his men. The captain ordered the other sailors to bring John before him because they were in danger. In anger, he grabbed him by the tail of his striped cap, twisted him thrice and flung him out of the sea. When John went before the captain grabbed in anger by the tail of his striped cap, twisted him thrice and flung him out of the sea. But the winds called up by the cap span the ship three times around. As John went under the waves, John was thrown into the sea. As John went under the waves, the cap came off his head. Soon the storm stopped as the cap removed from John's head, and John swam ashore. The cap followed John. When he got to the land, to his mother, John picked up the cap and ran home to his mother and returned back to his farm. Again in the winter, when the snow lay heavy on the fields and the cultivation stopped, he began to dream of the sea. John went to the wardrobe, got out of the fairy cap and stared at it for a long moment. When John remained in his house then, and he was dreaming about the sea, he went to the wardrobe where he put the cap in. He got out the fairy cap and stared means fixed look, stared at the fairy cap for a long moment, tucking it in his shirt. Putting the cap in his shirt, he ran out to the field. He placed the wind cap under a stone where he knew the fairy man would find the cap and take it. Then he left again for the seas again.